takes guts. You got to dig down deep to gut it out. Keep on going again and again and again until you make it happen, because you know that it's possible. Now, what do you do during the hard times, Les? Here's what you must do. Number one is you must have faith. Paul said you must have the faith to call forth those things that be not as though they were. Judge not according to appearances. Don't judge your circumstances and the possibilities for your future based upon what you have now and because of what's going on now. No, 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 no. That's not the real reality there. What you're going through, if you're going through some hard times, it has not come to stay. It has come to pass. It's all right. Now, second thing is, repeat this after me. Something you should affirm to yourself every day. Repeat this, please. No matter how bad it is, or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it. Say that to yourself every day. As I used to say to myself, when I would get up in the Penobscot building and I had to go into the bathroom and bathe in the bathroom sink, I had written on the mirror that I put up, they just paste up and I read, no matter how bad it is or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it. So you've got to have faith, you talk to yourself, you say that affirmation. The next step is you must have patience and engage in consistent action. Patience and engage in consistent action. See, everything does not always happen, ladies and gentlemen, when we want it to happen. It doesn't happen quickly. So in that process, they have something in the Far East called the Chinese bamboo tree. The Chinese bamboo tree, every day it has to be watered and fertilized. It's a very hard nut, and it takes 5 years of watering and fertilization every day, according to American Geographics, before it breaks through the ground. At any time, if the watering process and the nurturing and the fertilization process is stopped, the Chinese bamboo tree will die in the ground. Now, once it breaks through in that fifth year, then in 6 weeks it grows 90 feet tall. Now, the question is, does it grow 90 feet in 5 years or 6 weeks? The answer is obvious. It takes 5 years. That's how long it took to grow it, to build that foundation, to nurture it, to water it, to build the reputation, to build the credibility, to learn the market, to learn people, to learn yourself, to learn the system, to learn how to do it, to figure it out. That's why you must have patience and engage in consistent action. We live in a world, ladies and gentlemen, where people want instant gratification. They want it right now. They want to be a Dexter Yeager, but they're not willing to pay the price to do what it takes to get up there where Dick Hopper is, where Bryant or Judy is. They think it was easy. No, no. It's simple, but it's not easy. It's a system that if you work the system, it works if you work it. But make no mistake about it. It's hard. And you are the determining factor. Here's something else. It's possible you can live your dream. It's necessary that you have goals, that you write them down, that you surround yourself with a support team, that you are creative. It's you that you must take personal responsibility to make it happen. George Bernard Shaw said, the people that make it in this world look around for the circumstances that they want, and if they can't find them, they create them. It's hard. No, easy is not an option. However, ladies and gentlemen, what you will discover is that it's worth it. It's worth it. I suggest to you, if you want to become diamond, write down 5 reasons of why it is worth it for you to become a diamond, to experience that level of achievement. What is it that will give you the drive? What is it that will ignite the courage in you to get up and come back again and again and again. How is it that you would be able, what reasons that can tap in to that deep down feeling that goes to your gut, that no matter how many times you get knocked down, that you're coming back? What is it? Write it down. Let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. You saw that picture up there, the lady, Mrs. Mamie Brown. I'm flying from here tomorrow morning to be with my adopted mother. She's 87 years young, thank God. And I'll be with Mama tomorrow. Every Mother's Day, I don't care where I am, I go home Mother's Day, everybody knows, November 6th, my mother's birthday, I'm home. And I try to go home as often as I can. When I started and left Miami pursuing my dream, because I knew that as long as you work for someone else, they are controlling your destiny. I didn't want anybody signing my paycheck but me. I knew that it was going to be difficult. I knew it was going to be hard. But every time I thought about giving up, and there were times I did, because where I am, ladies and gentlemen, it's a long shot. You think being a diamond is a long shot. This is a miracle. This is a long shot. And I had people laughing at me. Les, you're talking about being a motivational speaker? You have no college training. You were labeled educable, mentally retarded. You failed twice in school. They put you back from the fifth grade into the fourth grade, and you fail in the eighth grade. You've never worked for a major corporation, and you are going to become independently wealthy. Right. They laugh. They're going to laugh at you. People are going to laugh at you. But let me tell you, I believe in revenge like Frank Sinatra. He said the best revenge is massive success. It's a long shot. Being here with you today in this dome, it's a long shot. No college training, labeled educable, mentally retarded, but I kept running toward my dream. Don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop running toward your dream. You can live your dream. What if we have that kind of attitude? The car's repossessed. Nobody believes in you. You've lost again and again and again. The lights are cut off, but you're still looking at your dream, reviewing it every day, and say to yourself, it's not over until I win. Life will yield to you.
You can't connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. You have to trust in something, your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. Because believing that the dots will connect down the road will give you the confidence to follow your heart, even when it leads you off the well-worn path. And that will make all the difference. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. You've got to find what you love, and that is as true for work as it is for your lovers. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking and don't settle. Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become.
But you're going to have some ups and you're going to have some downs. Most people give up on themselves easily. You know, the human spirit is powerful. There's nothing as powerful. It's hard to kill the human spirit. Anybody can feel good when they have their health, their bills are paid, they have happy relationships. Anybody can be positive then. Anybody can have a larger vision then. Anybody can have faith under those kinds of circumstances. The real challenge of growth, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, comes when you get knocked down.
It takes courage to act. Part of being hungry when you've been defeated, it takes courage to start over again.
Fear kills dreams. Fear kills hope. Fear put people in the hospital. Fear can age you, can hold you back from doing something that you know within yourself that you're capable of doing, but it will paralyze you.
At the end of your feelings is nothing. But at the end of every principle is a promise. Behind your little feelings, it might not be absolutely nothing at the end of your little feelings. But behind every principle is a promise. And some of you in your life, the reason why you're not at your goal right now, because you're just all about your feelings. You all on your feelings. You don't feel like waking up. So who does? Every day you say no to your dreams, you might be pushing your dreams back a whole 6 months, a whole year. That one single day, that one day you didn't get up, could have pushed your stuff back I don't know how long.
Don't allow your emotions to control you. We are emotional, but you want to begin to discipline your emotion. If you don't discipline and contain your emotions, they will use you. You want it, and you're going to go all out to have it. It's not going to be easy when you want to change. It's not easy. If it were in fact easy, everybody would do it. But if you're serious, you'll go all out. I'm in control here. I'm not going to let this get me down. I'm not going to let this destroy me. I'm coming back. And I'll be stronger and better because of it. You have got to make a declaration that this is what you stand for. You're standing up for your dreams. You're standing up for peace of mind. You're standing up for health. Take full responsibility for your life. Accept where you are and the responsibility that you're going to take yourself where you want to go. You can decide that I'm going to live each day as if it were my last. Live your life with passion, with some drive. Decide that you're going to push yourself. The last chapter to your life.
What do you desire? What makes you itch? What sort of a situation would you like? So I always ask the question, what would you like to do if money were no object? How would you really enjoy spending your life? Well, it's so amazing. As a result of our kind of educational system, crowds of students say, well, we'd like to be painters, we'd like to be poets, we'd like to be writers, but as everybody knows, you can't earn any money that way. Or another person says, well, I'd like to live an out-of-doors life and ride horses. I say, do you want to teach in a riding school? Let's go through with it. What do you want to do? When we finally got down to something which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that. And forget the money. Because if you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living, that is, to go on doing things you don't like doing, which is stupid. Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. And after all, if you do really like what you're doing, it doesn't matter what it is, you can eventually turn it, you could eventually become a master of it. The only way to become a master of something, to be really with it. And then you'll be able to get a good fee for whatever it is. So don't worry too much. Somebody's interested in everything. And anything you can be interested in, you'll find others who are. But it's absolutely stupid to spend your time doing things you don't like in order to go on spending things you don't like, doing things you don't like, and to teach your children to, follow in the same track. See, what we're doing is we're bringing up children and educating them to live the same sort of lives we're living, in order that they may justify themselves and find satisfaction in life by bringing up their children, to bring up their children to do the same thing. It never gets there. And so, therefore, it's so important to consider this question. What do I desire?